what is the real cause of the death of Bob Saget? So let me explain to you. His family said that the medical examiner said that he had a brain injury that led to his death, and something called subdural hematoma. So this is the human brain, and then in the brain is inside the skull, and then in between the brain and the skull there are small veins that are nourishing the brain and supplying the blood. And when somebody falls, especially in elderly, more than 65, they can have those veins to be sheared, and then they can ooze blood, not the artery, which is very high pressure, fast bleeding. They can be venous, very slow oozing blood over time. And then the blood can accumulate over time until it collects enough around the brain to push on the brain actually. And then this is something called herniation. When those vital parts of the brain, they are called the medulla, those were the sensation of the breathing centers and all of those vital function, they get compromised and somebody will stop breathing and their heart will stop, and that can lead to their death. So what are the signs that you should look for in somebody who had a head injury, fell down, hit their head, and suspected to have bleeding in the brain? The signs that you should look for are nausea, vomiting, confusion, prolonged loss of consciousness more than 5 minutes, or a seizure, or there is a weakness in one side of the body. So those signs can tell us that there is potentially might be bleeding in the brain, and you need to seek immediate medical attention to get images of the brain, and if there is bleeding, to deal with it either surgically or any other treatment modality. And we know that traumatic brain injury can cause irritation to the brain that leads to seizures down the line. And to learn more about seizures and traumatic brain injury, you can see this video. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one.